So hello everyone, I'm Marcin Rudolf. I'm a co-founder and a system designer of Neufund, which is a community-owned fundraising platform. Yes, and thanks for staying so long. I'm going to do it like in a very quick way, I hope. And yeah, I hope it's gonna be very interesting. All right, so so basically, Neufund is a community-owned fundraising platform. This is pretty extensive projects, and we had a lot of nice introductions to blockchain today. I'm gonna do another one from like my perspective. I think Trent has a background in artificial intelligence, so he sees a blockchain is a metaphor of like training some kind of evolutionary algorithms that behaves in a similar way. There is like an optimum that it seeks and so on. So my background is in computer science, but also sociology and system theory. So I'm gonna use this metaphor, and I think it's gonna be interesting because we had a pretty extensive token system in this platform, and it was designed with the people in mind, like people interactions and behavior. So yeah, so let's start with what is blockchain from my point of view, and a few other things that are like necessary to understand what I'm gonna talk about later. So basically, blockchain is it lets people to interact or make very complicated transaction without trusting each other. Yeah, so I know, let's take a look at internet, how it happened and how it changed society. So basically, internet is a way for people to communicate in the peer-to-peer fashion without intermediaries, yes? And this is not only the technology, yes? So we know the CIP stack and the HTTP stack and so on, but this is also a kind of revolution and impact it has on the society because it changed how people communicate. When you change how people communicate, you change everything because basically society is a communication system. So this is a huge impact. It was just a start, yes? Now we have a blockchain, and blockchain is more allows people to do more complicated things than just talk, yes? It allows people to make very complicated transactions without intermediaries. Yeah? So this is like a starting point in our system design. The next thing that people perceive as a technology, but basically this is something more. Yes, there are smart contracts. Smart contracts are interfaces for people to interact. They define some rules, they define some actors, they define some incentives, and then the system design basically is to align the incentives of the people that's gonna use it. Yes, this is not about writing code. It is of course very important to write good code, yes, afterwards. But it's also important to design the system in a way that people are doing what they're supposed to do. Yes, I think the trends are talk about that as well, yeah? So this is very similar, I think, approach. Then we have tokens that are basically a type of a smart contract. It's designed to represent some value, and it's designed to let people own something on blockchain, yes? So this is like the three definitions that I'm gonna use. Okay, so what is Neufund? Neufund is a community-owned fundraising platform, so it basically lets investors of any kind to found new projects, which in our case are hosting off-chain companies, yes, for which we are designing a new type of token to found this off-chain businesses that are sometimes not a blockchain type of businesses that is represented as a network, but a shoes factory or a car factory can also use the ICO process to fund this operation. Yes, so basically Neufund is a kind of legal, technological, and system structure that allows to do it, allows to found any kind of business in the world with any kind of money, not only the crypto money, but also it's a gateway for the classical investors, VCs that want to convert to blockchain. And leave this existing kind of framework when there is a lot of gatekeeping, a lot of very fragmented into something that is like organized as a really network of investors that can fund innovation. Yes, so Neufund has many different aspects. It's a product for the end user. It is also very complicated, elaborate legal framework that lets let token holders to hold real shares in the companies with all the shareholder rights and so on. But it is also a blockchain design system with the tokens that should align people to simply get together and fund innovation, fund new projects. Yes, so I'm going to talk about the tokens that we've got. And the first token I'm going to talk about, it's called a Neufund token. It's a token that basically represents the value of this platform. And okay, so I need to start with some basic introduction to what, in my opinion, is what is the very fundamental principle of blockchain economy? Yes, and you have it in the Bitcoin. So we always start with the Bitcoin, which is really something that revolutionized this kind of thing. And put it really this all these questions about the work, the value, and the ownership back into the rethinking mode. Yes, so. So basically, this principle is that whoever works for the network should own this network, yes? And then in Bitcoin, it's a pure example of this. So every Bitcoin was mined, yes? Every Bitcoin was created for providing useful work for this network. This, in that case, it's electricity, but this is like a creating this consensus via a proof of work. So everything was created this way. Every Bitcoin was mined, yes? It was a reward for creating this network, yes? So we have the same principle with Neufund, yes? So we need to reward people that work for us, for the platform, for this ecosystem that increase its value. And in our case, the investment is this kind of work, yes? So according to this principle, people that invest should own this network, should own this ecosystem, should be rewarded with the ownership. And this is exactly what the Neufund token is doing, yes? So Neufund token is not a kind of gatekeeper to investment, it is rather a kind of incentive, yes? So whenever there is an investment transaction, so someone funds a project, yes? Someone puts some money into some kind of cool project, creates an innovation, as we say. Our resource is innovation. I mean, like, So our resource that we create is innovation. Whenever this happens, this investor is rewarded with our token. Yes, this is like something that we grant on top of the actual investment. And this token, so this token cannot, it's not bought, it's not created, yes, out of the air. It is issued only when some useful work is done. And so this token has very specific value. This value is a share of the economic output of this ecosystem. So whenever there is a successful fundraising completed, it is a small part of this amount, a fee, is shared back to all the token holders of this platform. So this is one component. The second component is like a little bit also of the token of this project is also shared back. Yes. So this way, every investor that ever does investment on our platform or on the platform is also aligned with every company that was ever ICO'd in there, yes? So owns a little bit of share of everyone. This is like we call it a platform portfolio. So this very strongly aligns investors with the companies and also aligns investors together. All right. There is another Bitcoin concept, that's our tokens are easy mined at the beginning of like when the network is really young, yes, because at that point we need to really to kickstart it and make it going. So this reward is much higher than later, yes. So this reward rewards the risk takers, rewards the early adopters, and makes people coming to this platform. All right. So there is another very interesting consequence of this kind of thing that's. By the system design, we couldn't do the real ICO of our platform, yes? We did something different. It's called ICBM, and it stands for Initial Capital Bidding Mechanism, which you also could call Initial Community Building Mechanism, yes? Because this is an initial Neumark generating mechanism, yes, in which we do not sell any tokens. Yes, in this mechanism, people come and say, this platform has potential. I'm going to commit a little bit of money or reserve a little bit of money for the future investment. Yes, it happens in the escrow smart contract simply. I'm going to reserve a little bit of money. And for that already, we are rewarding this person with Neumark. Yes, this creates a kind of decentralized capital pool. People that already are committed to invest in the future, in the coming deals to the platform. And I mean, like solving a kind of chicken and egg problem when you don't have any capital and any deals. So this is building this capital side of the platform. Yes, and investors get the Neumarks, we call it Neumarks or Neu, yes, already in this process. Yes, so this also has an interesting mechanism that we, as a platform operator, we do not get any money from this. Yes, we do not get any money. All the money goes to the funding of the project in the future by individual investors' decisions. And what we get is a share of an OI that is created during this process. Yes, so I call this vesting without vesting, because we get this only when there's successful transaction on the platform. Yes, so we do not pre-allocate anything, we do not take anything before it really happens and it's really earned. The work is, I would say, done. Okay, so that was the Neu token. Okay, the other thing that is very important, it is, we call it equity token. Yes, and this is a very interesting topic from the legal perspective, but I will not be doing this. I can take any question about that, but I'm going to talk about something else. This is basically the whole thinking about how you can really invest with tokens. Yes, because the current situation, it is not so obvious how to do it with the existing token types, which we call utility tokens. Yes, so this tokens represents a kind of service or a voucher for some goods, and basically they are. Every blockchain or every proper blockchain project is a small economy. Yes, it has some resource that is created. This resource should be created in some optimal way. This, I mean, like a network should be in balance, yes, or in equilibrium. This equilibrium is expressed via token price. If you have a good token price, there is maximum number or amount of this goods is created. Yes, so this is like a small economy, and now you have the token that represents the value of this economy. It's called the utility token and represents directly the goods that are created in there. Yes, so So the problem is that this organic growth. Do I have it? Yes. Okay. This is here. So this organic growth of this kind of economy without any bootstrapping and without any capital that is coming in from outside, any value from outside, it's going slow. Yes, it's a network effect. Starts smaller. It took a lot of time for Bitcoin to start increasing in value massively. Yes, because that was this very long time when there was not many miners, the network was not simply funded, and so on. Yes, so people that create these tokens. Yes, right now the app tokens, they are trying to solve this problem, overcome this problem, and there are two ways to do it. One is doing this primary financing, which is called ICO. So basically you create your tokens in advance and you sell them, but they still represent a kind of good. I don't know, like you are selling a future computing power, yes, on a massive scale, for example. That's the one thing. The second thing, you are establishing a secondary market. Yes, and then you can trade this token and you can increase in value due to speculation of people betting on it and so on. So this secondary market basically drives the price of the Bitcoin now, yes? And the primary market is used by any kind of blockchain projects to obtain the initial funding. So there are two mechanisms that are used to put external value into app tokens. Okay, so this way the app token is losing its role of being a pure indicator of the network value, of a value of the resource that is produced inside. It's getting another role. This another role is an investment function. And this has some interesting consequences. And yeah, so to me, it was like I was spending some time on this. What does it mean to invest in app token? So to me, this like a metaphor is do you invest in Tesla, buying a lot of cars from the Tesla factory, yes, and then selling this on the secondary market. So this is not how to do it, yes? You basically buy a share of Tesla business instead of buying a lot of cars or voucher for cars. Doesn't matter much, yes? The other thing, I mean, like with an impact that it has on the resource, yes? We are deploying some smart contracts a year ago. Well, a little bit less than a year ago, yes? And we paid, like, I don't know, there was like one of these peaks, like $200 per smart contract system. A few months earlier, I would pay $1 for that, yes? Because the Ether was for $6, I think, per one. It was like this, I think this was December last year. And then the question is, did the price of computing power increase dramatically over these 3 months? No, it didn't, yes? So what happened? What happened? Why, as a consumer, as a user of this resource, I had to pay so much? And by the way, Ethereum has this gas price mechanism that is probably, I think it's by design, a way to decouple this price of Ethereum, which probably people that created Ethereum already predicted that it's going to be a problem with the Ethereum value. They try to decouple with the gas price. But it doesn't work because this market can't really stand so many changes coming from the speculators. So today I think we have a pump of 30%. And why should I pay 30% more for computing power? This is not explained by the resource itself. Yeah? Questions, yes?
Your contract became 100 times more secure. The security is 100 times greater.
I mean, like if Ethereum is just simple network has a Bitcoin, then yes, but Ethereum is a computing power, like a consensus computing power, yes, and my contracts are not much secure because there's a Turing machine in there, and most of the insecurity comes from that, yes. Of course, maybe we are talking about the billions of dollars, but our ESO plan is just for our employees, yes. So, I mean, like, we are not billion-dollar business yet, so, yeah. So, probably doesn't explain the increase. To me, as a consumer, yes, I'm talking about as a consumer in here. Okay, so we started to analyze this. Yes, why this is like that? Yes, and basically, if some external people come and put this network out of the equilibrium, this alignment between the people that produce this and then consume this resource, it simply goes away. Yes, because what this consumer and the miner want, they want to maximize the output of the network. So as many goods are produced as possible. This is the optimum state, yes? So as much computing power as possible, as can be consumed, and so on. But investor has a little bit different, or speculator has a little bit different approach, yes? They want to pump this up or pump it down or dump it, the price according to some short-term speculative, gains that they can take it, yes? So. So we destroy equilibrium this way. So network is not in optimum, let's say, state. It doesn't produce as much good as it should. Okay, so there is another thing, yes? This is what I heard many times. Why should I ever sell and use my Bitcoins? They are so valuable, so I just better keep it and don't use it, yes? And now there is a problem. Is Bitcoin has any kind... I know that the Bitcoin right now is more like a gold, or you don't really touch it. Gold is basically useless in some way. It's just a store of value. But let's say you have another type of network that has some other usage, let's say a file storage or something like that, and you have a lot of investors, they pump the price up of the token, and then people stop using this. Because the price is too high. If you have this token, you will not sell it because you think this is a good value, and the consumer will not use it. So this is very well-known, I think, well-known mechanism for, I don't know, hundreds of years, yes? That you have two alternatives, yes? One is one is gold and one is a cheap thing, yes? But works as alternative substitute or functional substitute. This cheap thing is gonna win, yes? And this better money, this gold money, I mean, like this shitcoin will remove the gold coin basically at the end, yes? And this is like the kind of law that was discovered, I don't know, by Copernicus, by the way. That's very interesting. Okay, there is another issue that you can't really do a secondary round with your up token. The up token, if it really represents a value and you have established price and you generate 30% more of these tokens and you sell it, then you can really destroy business of the miners. Yes, they will just take the rigs and go somewhere else. Okay, so I mean, we went in the simplest possible solution, looking at the how humanity is dealing with this problem off-chain. Yeah? So there is this very interesting invention of equity. Yes, equity is a sharing business, can represent any kind of business model. I mean, maybe this has a bad opinion right now because there are really a lot of corporations that are greedy and so on. But the concept itself, a kind of abstraction of any kind of business model, when someone that has equity, has some stake in the output of the business, in some stake in governance, information that is there, but it's not impacting how this business works. This is good and this is very interesting. So right now, Neufund is focusing on doing this this bridge between the equity off-chain and tokens on-chain. Yes, but this could be only a start to solve this problem because you can also represent this kind of share of business, yes, a share in the network via another token. Yes, that doesn't represent a value of the resource. It just represents the economic output. Yes, so when you have this token, you want to optimize the output of the network, like a miner or a user, because if this is producing more, you get more economic value out of this. Yes, so you don't really want to influence the price of this just for speculation. So yeah, so that's it. By the way, we have this ICBM open. It's already going. We have pretty nice network of investors off-chain and on-chain. So yeah, you can check it. And that's it. Yeah. So yeah, that's all. Thanks. Okay, this is my time. So yeah. Yeah, this is gonna be end of Q1 right now. Yeah.
Okay. And do you have already concrete projects?
Yeah, we have. I can't list them, but they are pretty interesting projects from many different angles. Some of them are, I don't know, some of them deal with hardware. There are a few later stage projects, gaming companies. There are some creative agencies that are interested and so on. Yes, so we have pretty interesting deal coming in. We also have pretty interesting investors, which also bring some deal flow. We have people from Early Bird invested. We have people from Sandstone, from Mangrove, from Atlantic Labs. We also have interesting people from the crypto space. I think also Brian is supporting us and other people. So I mean, this is more community building mechanism for us than capital building, because the size of this ICO doesn't really matter. We're already very happy with what happened. Basically, we need to convince every single investor almost separately, which I thanks to my team for doing that, because this concept is pretty complicated. Yes, we don't do the ICO, we do some kind of fund commitment, we generate tokens as a reward, we don't take these funds. People at start do not understand this, so we need to really work with everyone separately.
Did I get this right, that each investor invests in every project, which is the platform?
Okay, so this is how this token works, yes? So when you invest in a single project, yes, you are like a miner to us. You provide a useful way to create a value, yes, because you invest in innovation. For that, you are getting a reward, which is a token that's generated just for you at the moment of this transaction, and this token, the value of this token is in the fees, yes. But also there is something, a construct that you can think this is a kind of index fund or something like this that holds a little bit of tokens of every project that ever was funded on the platform, and you have a stake in this. I mean, okay, so there are a few layers of this, yes? So first of all, Neufund is providing this legal bridge. So we are, as a platform, are checking this basic legal You are doing this basically due diligence. So the company exists, the team exists, you really know who is it, there is KYC being done on the founders and so on. So you know that at least this is a legit business that is somewhere incorporated and so on, yes? But we do not judge the merits of the project itself, yes, if it's a good business or bad. This we do it at start, yes, together with our investors and so on, to provide a good deal flow that is already curated, but later you do not want to do it, you just want to provide incentives for experts or some SEO facilitators, yes, to earn money when the, I think this is always a similar concept, yes? We're gonna let them stake on a project, yes? And then if the SEO was successful, this ETO or this fundraising, they're gonna get a little bit of share of this money that was being simply from the funding, yes? So there is this incentive. Also, the ICO process itself is a kind of vesting mechanism, yes, for the project. Because then people vote with their money. If the terms are not met, then the money is going back to the investors. So there are many layers that are checking if this project is really legit and a good business, good opportunity. Yeah?
The quantity of the new generated Neu tokens will be fixed or will be increasing over time?
This is a very interesting question. And we went for the fixed cap, yes? So there is a kind of limit to how many Neumarks are generated. Okay, I have the reverse curve here with the decreasing reward. Okay, but there is a cap, and we believe that that at some point this early incentivization scheme is not necessary, so the Neumarks will be generated very high difficulty, so almost no Neumarks per invested ether. And yeah, then you can get Neumarks on the secondary market, yes, if you like the platform. So there is a cap, yes.
It's running on Ethereum.
This is a smart contract system and D app on Ethereum. Yes, and yeah, that's right.
So, yeah, but what level is the cap set?
Yeah, the cap is set for 1.5 billion of Neu, which is more or less 1.5 billion of euro. Yes, I think that at that point you are getting like a less than. Less than one Neumark pen, when the last less than one Neumark 100 of euro. So
and the 1.5 billion euro is not the money you're going to invest in the projects.
No, this is exactly the money that is gonna be. Please continue. Okay, so this is exactly the amount of money that's gonna be invested in the project, because the Neu is generated only when there's investment. This is not even a kind of exception, but we generate this Neumarks on the commitment now, yes? But they need to be spent, yes? If you do not spend them, you can take your money back if you don't like the platform, but you need to return this Neumark from this. You need to return this Neumark if you receive the Neumark during the commitment process, yes? So before you invest it.
So let's say I want to invest like, I don't know, 50 Ether or something like
yeah.
that.
Yeah.
And then after a year or so, I say I want to withdraw like 20 or so. I need money to pay my rent. I want to have some money back for
yeah.
5 years or so. How does that work?
How does it work? So you need to, okay, this is a smart contract. Okay, so I don't know, from the user perspective or system perspective, you need to, yes, so you need to or still have or acquire Neumarks that you've got for free, yes, in this commitment and send them back to the smart contract, and then Ether is gonna go back to your wallet. Yes, and you can take it. There is nothing more. And of course, if you spend, if you decide to invest on one of the projects, this doesn't apply anymore. Spend money simply frees your Neu forever. Yes, you do not return anything and so on. So this is one of the incentives for spending this money on the fundraising.
But I don't want to spend my money forever. I mean, usually when you invest, at some point you want to get back something.
Okay,
after 10 years or so.
Yeah. So in case, I mean, like, this is one of the things why you are doing this on blockchain, yes, because you can invest this money in a kind of token, yes, that gives you a shareholder rights, but this token can be liquid, yes, very quickly. It's that you are, this is not a VC world when you stay 7 years with your portfolio and wait for the exit. You can do it here as well. This is your choice, but you can also sell, yes, and this is a very powerful mechanism because as we see. I don't know. I'm gonna take this example. As you can see, I mean, speculators are sometimes good for the business, yes, because they come, they think they're gonna make a lot of money, they put a lot of money into the project, and they can withdraw. Some of them lose, some of them win, but they are driving this money into different businesses, yes. Sometimes this has a not very good effect, like funding something that is stupid, but sometimes you fund some cool things this way. So this liquidity is not bad, yes, for. Maybe for the seed, it's not a good idea to be liquid. But for some A round or even later stage, people dream about that often, or have a gray market for their shares. Like most of the bigger companies that are private have gray market. Okay. Yeah, Trent, come.
I've always been a fan of this project, so it's very cool. Thanks for the explanation. My main question is, overall, this is for people who would have normally done a regular startup company, right? And where they're not trying to create some sort of tokenized ecosystem, they just want something that's more like shares, that's more fluid.
Yeah, yes.
And that's cool. So which jurisdictions are you aiming for? Is it for like German companies, or is it for American?
So basically, Neufund is German GmbH, yes? So the offerings of the tokens will be according to the regulated by the German law, right. Yes, but anyone can do it in the world. I mean, you just need a proper legal system in a given country, yes, that is more or less stable and has a corporate, yes, a structure in there, so you can have shares that right. You can sell. But basically, you can do it, and this is like on DAX, there are like companies from outside of Germany. This is not a different problem.
So one quick follow-up is simply, this is actually cool because I know, like, you know, we're Beaching to be as a German GmbH, of course, you know, every time you take in one new investor, all the existing investors have to, well, you and I were talking, they all have to sign, right? And so this actually really reduces friction if it's basically you have a previous sort of company startup model, but now it's just way, way lower friction for sort of dealing with a lot of the legals. And I guess that's one of the main value propositions of Neufund. That you basically have a more lightweight approach to handling some of the legal.
Yeah, so tokens are much more flexible. Yes, when you tokenize part of equity, there is more freedom, yes, for you as a funder, yes, and for the early investor as well. Yes, so of course, the having a part of your company public, this also means that you have gonna have some kind of market valuation for this part. So this is really, I don't know, dilemma that you need to solve, yes, for your company if you wanna do it or not. But you don't need to trade, yes, you can tokenize and do the peer-to-peer transfers, not no official trading and so on. Yeah, there is a question from.
If I invest in at least one project, so in future I get rewarded a little bit from every project.
Yes.
What you said.
Yeah.
So how is the relationship? How much do I have to invest in one project, and how much do I get out of the other? Where's the link between?
You are asking about the numbers, exact numbers.
I invest 50 Ether, like you said.
Okay, so I would need to do some computations, yes, because you have a 50 Ether. So in 50 Ether, I think Ether right now is 900 Noi, more or less. So multiply by this, and this is a small share of the platform, yes, because probably gonna to have a significant, returns from Ether, you need to invest a little bit more, yes, but. From 50 Ethers? Mm-hmm. Yeah, so how much is half 1.5 billion euro in Ether?
No.
Yeah.
No, but
I mean, like, but you know, I mean, the noise incentivization scheme, yes, and you shouldn't look at noise as the only driving factor for this platform. You first of all invest in a project that you support, yes. You should have Ethereum from this. Then you can trade this noise if you don't like it for some reason, yes. So the fees are for hodlers, yes. If they like this platform, they will keep this and they will be rewarded for that. Yes, we want people to be aligned. They want people to stay, to invest, and so on. Also, someone that has this noise, it's in the interest of this person to increase the number of investment, not directly, but maybe by organizing deals or working as an expert or working as some kind of syndicate organizers. I don't know. This, yeah.
I think maybe just to clarify the last question. I think when you invest, you're not investing in specific projects, right? You're just investing in the whole Neufund fund.
You can't do it. You need to invest in specific projects to get this reward in form of Neumark, which aligns you with the rest of the ecosystem. Yes?
Okay,
this is a reward on top.
Your money goes to a specific company, yeah. But then what you get back represents the whole thing.
Yes. Okay. But also you get, of course, the share of this company in form of equity token. Yes,
so you get the share of that specific company.
Okay, so I'm going to explain this like a different way. Okay?
So you get actual shares.
Yeah, you get actual shares.
Like legally.
Yeah. I mean, like you get with current, let's say, status of the legal system in the world, yes, you are getting something that is as close as possible to shares with all the rights of a shareholder, but this is still a token. So you are represented externally. This is all in our white paper. You are with a kind of transparent proxy, legal proxy, which is a kind of law firm that is doing everything you want with the company, yes, voting for you and so on. This is, yeah.
I mean, today I think we had actually a BaFin announcement that in Germany tokens are considered as units of account,
true.
Not as security. So what does that mean? That means if you buy a token, you have no right.
No. So this is, of course, not true.
In the company, mm-hmm. if I may continue.
Mm-hmm, of course.
As if I would have when I buy a share. If I go to DAX and I buy an Apple share, I have a voting right there. If I buy a token.
You also have a voting right.
According to BaFin regulation and announcement, you don't.
So first of all, BaFin said that this, I mean, what is a unit of account? It's a number of someone on someone's, okay, this is the basic denominator of all the kind of accounting things, like money, shares, and so on. So they said that the token is like a balance on someone's account, nothing else. And they also said that in the particular cases, they gonna to look into the function of the token, and they said, what is it, yes? So we are pretty sure, because we are like in contact and working basically with the BaFin for a year now, that these tokens will be considered security, and we are totally ready for it. Yes, so there will be.
You have to set up a prospectus and just like as.
I mean, like depending on the ticket sizes and then how big is the investment. Then yes, there are different kinds of prospectus or different requirements. Yes,
okay.
For some bigger deals with big tickets, you don't need a prospectus.
Okay.
200,000 euro, I think, ticket.
Exactly.
Yes.
Okay, so wait. If you could finish the answer to my question. So I invest in one company. I get kind of virtual shares.
You get the
actual company plus I get tokens.
Yes,
okay.
You get tokens because you were a good player. Yes, you increase the value of this ecosystem, like a miner in Bitcoin. Yeah.
So it's like extra incentivization on top.
Yeah,
of,
and then
being able to invest in companies just through Neufund.
I mean, what do you mean?
You're saying that I can invest in a company.
I mean, this is not a good metaphor, because you invest, you have Ether or Euro or Bitcoin, anything else. Nothing prohibits. This is a contract that you can put money in. You need to do the KYC. Yeah, that's true, on Neufund. Yes, but this is not like you invest for Neufund, because this is an API that is exposed by smart contract. You can create my Ether wallet and do the transaction if you want. Yes, you don't need to use any kind of UI for that. Yes, but you need to prove of KYC to be stored on chain, And right now the regulations are that we need to do it. We would like to trust someone and just leave it this problem, but right now we need to do it. So you need to come at least to do the KYC for your Ether account. Yes?
Okay, great. And then you pick the companies that people are allowed
yeah,
to invest.
Yeah, this money is still yours. True. Mm-hmm.
But you pick the companies that are allowed to invest in, right?
Okay, so the companies need to come, do the basic due diligence, like the legal stuff I talk about. Like we need to know what the company exists, the team exists, the KYC is done for the organization, for the people. But then, I don't like this phrase, but market decides, yes, what happened, yes? If the deal is going to have any impact and the traction in the community, probably it's going to go somewhere and people are going to invest. If not, the ICO going to go down, yes, and the people are going to get a refund. Okay.
I don't know whether I got it right, but as far as I understand it, if I have a startup, it doesn't matter whether it's a blockchain startup mm-hmm. or any other, and I want to raise money,
yeah.
I can come to you, mm-hmm. my fund, and say, okay, I want to tokenize my company, yeah? And through Neufund, I want to raise money through the investors in Neufund, yeah? That's the idea.
Yeah, but our investors are basically, can be anyone that has Ether or Euro, yeah? So, I mean, I'm saying that this is not like some kind of closed club of investors, yes? This is a very open structure.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay, okay, that's cool.
Anybody can invest mm-hmm. in Neufund, so it's a crowdfunding mechanism, basically. You're asking how to invest. But I, as a company, if I'm a founder, I want to raise money, mm-hmm. I go to your platform, you check me, you check my team, mm-hmm. you check that I have a legal business and so mm-hmm. on and so forth, yeah? Then I can go on the platform and you don't do any further due diligence, so to speak, and say, okay, like a normal VC, they would actually do a due diligence and say, okay, we take those 5 or 10 companies in our portfolio and that's where we put the money of our investors. You don't do that. Yeah, you say, okay, the market decides who of the retail investors will basically give me with my company money, yeah?
Right.
Yeah, if you, I think your chances are much greater if you or bring some investors to the platform or know someone there. This is like, there are no magic money, yes, that's gonna just come to you. Yes, you need to campaign. You need to present some kind of proof that there is an interest, yes?
Okay.
So the best way to do it but is to find some kind of syndicate that's gonna do it for you.
Okay.
First step.
As an investor, if today I wanna invest in the startup field, yeah? And if I have enough money, I go directly to a VC and say, okay, here's €1 million, invested for me, yeah? And I trust you that you guys do the due diligence on the 5 companies you're gonna invest it in. And in 10 years time, I come back and I wanna have an average return of 20-something percent per year.
I mean, like, not, no, the mechanism today, yeah, this is exactly the mechanism, yeah.
Mechanism
but on Neufund, or?
What's your mechanism here?
If I'm an investor,
if I have a
So this is like an investment, it's like a marketplace, right? Like, you have this, like, aux money, or like, lending marketplaces, or equity marketplaces.
Yeah.
This is just the infrastructure, right? Like, afterwards, the projects, like, investors choose them. It's not their job, right, to say what
and
we currently
I mean, like,
I decide with my money, I have, but I don't have the choice, like, or do I have the choice to decide, like you have, like, 100 companies on there, on
mm-hmm.
the Neufund platform, and I can choose, I want to invest in company number 10 and number 15.
Yeah, then you choose. This is exactly like a stock market is working. I don't know, I didn't want to use this metaphor, but the stock market is also a pool of network of investors.
Okay.
And it is, of course, forcing the companies that are doing any business on the market to a little bit to conform to many different things.
Fine.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I actually have a way to help explain to you.
Yeah.
So given that you're already an investor, right? So a company comes to you, and they're like, hey, invest in us, right? And you've decided to invest in them anyway. Well, if you want some magic internet money on top of that, called Neu money, Neu tokens, then you take that startup to you say, hey, go on Neufund because I'm going to invest in you, and then I get Neu tokens, right? Is Neu coin?
Yeah, Neumark.
But so actually, Neumark. So overall, then basically, VCs and seed investors, angels, all this, they're actually incentivized to basically keep acting like they already are for investing, doing their regular process, but getting all those companies onto here, right?
Okay.
So that's maybe...
Yeah, that's
the way you are going to make money is basically because you get 50% of the Neumark generated.
So. Yeah, so whenever there's an investment, you get one Neumark goes to investor, one Neumark goes to us. But keep in mind, we do not take any money from ICBM. So this is the only thing that is, okay, this is our revenue stream. No, but
I want to understand how this works. Initially, the Neumark basically, the value is more or less zero because I can't trade it today. Yeah.
But right now, there is just a primary market for Neumarks in the commitment. The secondary market, I think it's gonna organically grow simply, yes? So
you're gonna list it on some exchange on
maybe someone's gonna list it.
Huh?
I mean, like, the listing on exchanges is a totally different thing, yes? And the value of Neumark shouldn't come from secondary trading, at least to me as a system designer. It should come from the fees, it should come from the, but as a Golem token? Okay. We are in the business model of this. So maybe let me return to this. Where is this? Oh, okay, it doesn't work anymore. Okay.
That's the interesting part.
Okay, so what is the business model of the platform? Yes, because we are just one of the token holders. So we have exactly the same alignment as other token holders. Yes, so we want to make as many investments in good projects as is possible. Yes, because then we optimize our. So this works like that. Whenever this ETO finished, yes, a small percent of this money that was in the escrow of the smart contract should go to the company. A small percent goes back to all the token holders, yes, that's what the company is paying. And a little bit of equity of this company in form of tokens goes to a special structure inside the platform, which I don't want to use this name, but it's the most similar to the index fund that is automatically optimized. Right now, it's not optimized, just keeps everything in there and stays there. And you have a right, economic right to this structure. Like if there's any exit proceeds, dividends, you get a payout as a Neumark holder from this. Yes, we have two components. One is equity, one is cash. And basically, if you have Neumarks, you have rights to all the future payouts and to this structure of equity tokens. Okay. For the buffing, if you want to organize trading, secondary trading, there is a buffing license required, but we are not in the trading business, yes? For the issuance of if you issue this kind of token, you in some cases need a prospectus, yes? And that you need to fill with buffing and have a statement from them that the prospectus is okay and you can proceed. That's true. Yeah, so this is actually pretty complicated because there is this crowdfunding regulations that I think are under 5 million or something. Yeah, there is very simple kind of prospectus, yes? Then you have under 200,000 ticket, there is no rules. It's like an accredited investor in US probably. When you take everything, there is a prospectus requirements, yes? But actually prospectus can be generated almost automatically if you have a proper pitch and budget and a few other things. Yeah, what's so funny?
I would guess some people are going to lose big money.
Yeah, of course. I would rather say they're going to make some money.
Do you know that VC investment is a game for rich boys, because it's you don't make money on it.
Yeah, I think the long-term return of any business, like 100 years, is below zero. That's true. We are getting to so generic level that it is true.
I recommend to you to read the Kaufman Foundation report on VC investment, and they analyze the real data.
Yeah, of course.
100 billion, and this is below.
Yeah, that is true, and I'm just saying that it's not only VC business, but any business that exists in the economy of this world, at the very end pays everything back to the society, and basically the value is lost at some point. It's even below zero, the return of everything. Equals is really, you don't believe me, but this is already was checked, yes, and probably you can find some interesting reports.
Later.
Yeah, sure.
I know that
yeah, so I don't know. That's I hope. Yeah, I answered the questions. Okay, thank you.